Welcome to this session, students. In this session, we're going to look at the second story in your syllabus, which is titled, How Much Land Does a Man Need? This is a very famous short story by the renowned Russian writer Leo Tolstoy. And I am, of course, your resource person and your English professor, Dr. Shayanti Talwar. So before we go to the story, let's have a look at the author. So Leo Tolstoy was born in the year 1828 and he died in the year 1910. And he was not only a renowned and thought-provoking writer of his times and in fact of all times, but he was also noted as a philosopher. There was a very deep philosophy that ran through all his works. He's best remembered for his novels, Anna Karenina and the widely translated War and Peace. He was both a moral thinker and a social reformer. So his works address social issues. They also address and focus on human virtues and vices, the evils that are around us. So you can say on many occasions, his works end with a moral. They have a definite end and there's a definite message in his works. In fact, you'll be surprised to know that the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, was deeply influenced by Tolstoy's thoughts and his worldview and the philosophy that he advocated and championed. Now, before we go to the actual story, let's look at what the text is about. This particular story was written in the year 1886. And it was a part of Tolstoy's collection, which was called Stories for the People, right? So it is the common man, which is always focused in his stories, like you can make out from the title itself, that it's Stories for the People. This particular story is set in rural Russia, and it centers around a peasant family that's and particularly around a farmer whose name is Pahom, right? So he's the main character of the story. And in fact, if we had to look at critical response to this story, the noted English writer James Joyce said that this was the finest story he had ever read. So that kind of validates the literary and the philosophical and the moral worth of the story that we are about to read.